Ladybird presents Topsy and Tim, the complete audio collection by Jean and Gareth Adamson. Read by Kate Rawson and Daniel Weyman.
Topsy and Tim go on an aeroplane. Topsy and Tim were off on their summer holidays. They were going in an aeroplane. The airport was very big. Topsy and Tim had a long ride in a bus to reach the terminal building. Then they had a long ride on an escalator to get to the right part of the building. Their luggage went for a long ride too, on a moving platform. Topsy and Tim watched an aeroplane land. It looked much bigger when it was not in the sky. The door was high off the ground.
"How will the people get out?" asked Topsy.
"Through a special tunnel," said Mummy. "You will see when it's our turn to get on the plane." The loudspeaker voice announced that Topsy and Tim's aeroplane was ready. Soon they were walking along a telescopic tunnel and stepping into the aeroplane. It looked like a very long bus.
"Welcome aboard," said the stewardess to Topsy and Tim.
The stewardess helped Topsy and Tim fasten their safety belts. She gave them some comics and some sweets.
"Suck a sweet when the aeroplane starts to fly," she said. "It will stop your ears hurting."
Tim took two sweets.
"One for each ear," he said.
The stewardess laughed.
"They go in your mouth, not your ears," she said.
The big aeroplane flew up into the sky. Topsy and Tim watched trees and houses grow as small as toys.
"My ears have gone funny," said Topsy. "You didn't suck your sweet, that's why," said Tim.
Topsy and Tim were flying above the clouds. "Isn't this exciting?" said Mummy. But the clouds went on for miles and miles. Topsy and Tim began to fidget. Lunch came in interesting plastic trays. Each piece of food had its own shaped space, like the pieces of a jigsaw puzzle. Topsy and Tim tried to swap pieces. The stewardess had to clear up the mess. Then she said, "Topsy and Tim, the pilot would like to talk to you." The stewardess took Topsy and Tim to the pilot's cabin.
"Hello, twins," said the pilot. "I've been hearing about you."
He showed Topsy and Tim all the switches and levers and dials he used to fly the aeroplane.
"Do you think you could fly my aeroplane?" asked the pilot.
Topsy and Tim were not sure. They went back to their seats and fastened their safety belts once more. Then they pretended to be pilots.
"Will you land our aeroplane now, please, pilots?" asked the stewardess.
Topsy and Tim could see the flaps moving in the aeroplane's wings to make it fly lower.
"I'm doing that when I move this lever," said Tim.
But Topsy and Tim both knew the real pilot was doing it. Topsy and Tim's aeroplane landed with hardly a bump.
"Goodbye, everybody," said Topsy and Tim.
They waved goodbye to the stewardess and to the pilot up in the aeroplane's nose. Then they went to meet their luggage on another moving platform. Soon, Topsy and Tim were playing on a sunny holiday beach. A big aeroplane flew across the sky.
"That's our plane going home," said Tim.
Topsy and Tim waved to their aeroplane, and they thought it waggled its wings back at them.
Topsy and Tim go on a train. Topsy and Tim were going to visit their granny. They were going by train because Granny lived a long way away. "Hurry up, Topsy and Tim," said Mummy. "We mustn't miss our train." They were taking lots of luggage with them, so Mummy called a taxi to drive them to the station. "I wish we could go faster," said Tim. "We'll miss the train." "No, we won't," said Mummy. They reached the station with plenty of time to spare. The kind taxi driver found a special trolley for their bags. Topsy and Tim helped push it through the booking hall. People were queuing to buy tickets at the ticket office. "I'm glad I came to buy our tickets yesterday," said Mummy. "Now we don't have to join that queue." "Our train leaves from platform 2," said Mummy. She showed their tickets to the platform guard. "Platform 2 is over the bridge," he told them. "Phew," said Tim as they pushed their trolley up the slope to the bridge. "Whee!" said Topsy as they trundled it down the other side. There was a little shop on the platform. Topsy and Tim chose some comics to look at on the journey. A lot of people were waiting for the train. At last, a loudspeaker told them that it had arrived. "Here's our train," shouted Topsy. "I saw it first," said Tim. It was quite a scramble to get onto the train. "Stay close to me and mind the gap between the train and the platform," said Mummy. There was a squash inside the train too, but clever Mummy found some empty seats. "I want to sit by the window," said Tim. "It's not fair," said Topsy. "I want to sit by the window." Luckily, there were two empty window seats, so everyone was happy. A whistle blew and the train began to move. "We're off," said Mummy.
"Hooray!"
shouted Topsy and Tim. Soon the train was rushing through the countryside. Topsy and Tim looked out of the window to see what they could spot.
"I can see a pony," said Topsy.
"I can see some cows," said Tim.
"Tickets, please," said a friendly voice.
It was the ticket inspector. He had come to check their tickets.
"Are you off on your holidays?" he asked.
"We're going to stay with our granny," said Topsy.
"Can I come too?"
asked the ticket inspector, but he was only joking.
"Are we nearly there?" asked Tim.
"Not yet," said Mummy. The door at the end of the carriage opened and a lady pushed a rattling trolley towards them. It was filled with things to eat and drink.
"Would you both like a sandwich?"
asked Mummy.
"I want a ham sandwich," said Tim. "A cheese sandwich, please," said Topsy.
They both had some orange juice and Mummy had a cup of coffee. Suddenly, the train rushed into a long, dark tunnel. It made the carriage look gloomy and strange.
Ooh, said Topsy. "My ears feel funny," said Tim.
"Drink some orange juice," said Mummy. "Then they'll feel better." At last, the train stopped at Granny's station.
There's Granny!
Shouted Topsy and Tim. They both wanted to hold Granny's hand.
"I'm glad I've got two hands," laughed Granny.
"I wish I had three," said Mummy.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.